to another fall video, guys. So I'm really excited for fall, and as you guys could see in the background, I'm going to be having a fall room tour really soon. Everything's coming out great. I just need more DIYs because my wall's kind of blank over there. That's fallen. I just need to readjust and do some more DIYs for you guys. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do some awesome pumpkins. This one was going to be a chevron pumpkin, but it ended up not coming out right since my math skills aren't that great, so I need to work on that. But I think it still came out pretty awesome, and as you guys could tell, another pumpkin back there. Some other awesome DIYs that don't have to involve pumpkins if you don't have them. And yeah, everything's pretty much free and affordable. Gonna choke there. But this fall scarf is nice and everything, but it's kind of been really hot, so I can't wear that. It's like getting kind of warm and you need to turn my fan on. And let's get started into this DIY. Okay guys, to make some awesome pumpkins, of course you're going to want some books, the big, small kind, X-Acto knife, box cutter, scissors, marker. Go ahead and make a half circle shape like a pumpkin. Go ahead, whatever you prefer, you know, to cut everything on out. Go ahead and cut the first piece off and continue cutting all the pages. Be sure to have some awesome favorite music blasting so you guys could get this through and over with within like 5 minutes. It doesn't take that long at all, and it comes out really cool and awesome. You'll be done with it before you guys know it. Of course, you could have a little bit of spray paint on it to give it a little hint of some orange or whatever color you're into. So go ahead and put the back piece and glue down a piece of a branch, and you guys are done. You got your awesome pumpkin. So just glue your branch on down and glue the back pages, and you got your awesome pumpkin. How awesome is that? So you guys are gonna want some duct tape, paints, paint brushes, you know, all the good stuff, paper towel rolls. You guys could of course use duct tape if you don't want to use paint, you know, just common essential tools. So you guys just go ahead, paint your toilet paper rolls or cover it all in duct tape like I'm doing here, whatever you guys want. We're gonna be making some pretty cool owls, so you could do it either way, it doesn't really matter. Just go ahead and push your top down like so, so you get that little cool curve shape. So you guys are gonna get like the head shape of your owl. Now of course, you guys, if you're doing the duct tape one, get a piece of duct tape and overlap it like so, and cut tiny little small half circle shapes to count as the feather parts on your little owl. So go ahead and cut a bunch of those little pieces out. You could use tape on the back, you guys could use glue. I recommend glue and not little pieces of duct tape because they're gonna pop right on off. Be sure to use some good glue. You have a little half circle heart shape, two circles, beak, you guys know, just like stuff. You can make your owl however you want. I just like guesstimated how I wanted everything to be, and I just put it all together. The like half kind of heart shape thingy is like the feet, what it's supposed to be. So I just have a little piece of tape stickiness on that part, putting it under the feathers, and of course it just looks pretty awesome like an owl. Now of course I didn't want to use a little piece of black duct tape, so I just colored it in with some Sharpie. I got little short oval shapes for the little wings of the bird, and yeah, that's how you guys just make your awesome duct tape owls. They're pretty self-explanatory and pretty awesome. Now of course, to make the painted ones, you're gonna do the same thing. Give it that little cool curve shape on the top for the head. Then you guys just go ahead, get your Sharpie, whatever marker you're into, and start doodling on your little owl. So just go ahead, give it some nice eyes, and get really creative with this. Look up inspiration, draw a beak, go ahead, draw little feathers, circles, triangles, whatever you guys are into, and just get creative with it. It's really fun. So have some more duct tape, some pumpkins, of course, you know, X-Acto knife, scissors, whatever you guys are into. Go ahead and cut your duct tape into whatever you guys like. I'm just cutting it into some strips. So I went ahead and put a chrome strip and some little squares all over my pumpkin. And now I'm putting on some little googly eyes just to give it a little fun theme. I don't know, I thought it looked pretty cool. So I'm just adding on some googly eyes like so. And for the little box shapes, I just made them like a, what do you call it? You know, I made it like that diamond pattern thing. Now, of course, you guys are going to want like a glass jar or vase or whatever, and you're going to want a pumpkin face cut out. Now, of course, I have this that I put my pumpkin from last year, so I don't have to cut it out. But just go ahead and use your duct tape and make like a duct tape sticker you want on your vase or whatever, and just stick it on like so, and it works nice and awesome. And that duct tape is from a year ago, so it's pretty awesome. Now, you could go ahead and doodle on your other pumpkin, whatever you guys want. Here's some doodle inspiration, and yeah, you guys just go ahead and doodle whatever you like. I'm doing a tiger pattern from doing stitches to these awesome spider webs, and yeah, that's how you do all these awesome DIYs. Got nothing in my brain. That's what people say.